Well, hello there, and welcome to another online worship opportunity with the Community of Faith of Alamance Lutheran Church. I'm Pastor Ron Philibaum. We're down at our ball field for the Plaid Festival, which will be this weekend, and we're awfully excited about that. You know, in these days in between Ascension and Pentecost, we gather with the disciples in the upper room, waiting for the Spirit to transform the church around the world. In today's gospel, Jesus prays. He prays for his followers and for their mission in his name. Amid religious, social, and economic divisions, we seek the unity that Jesus had with his Father, made one in baptism. We go forth to live our faith in the world, eager for the unity that God intends for the whole human family. So come along with us today as we learn and we grow together. Come on along. Well, it has been a busy week preparing for this Plaid Festival, but we are ready, and tomorrow is going to be a big day. So let's just take a moment to quiet ourselves before God and to clear away any worries or concerns or anything left over from last week that might just be circling around our heads and our minds. And let's bow our heads in prayer. Lord, open our hearts to see you more clearly and hear you in the words of your text, to be inspired so we can be sent into the community on your behalf. Please allow the words of my mouth and the meditation of my heart to be acceptable to you, our Lord, our Rock, and our Redeemer. Amen. Well, it has been quite a week. With constant motion, I've been reminded of a book called Courageous Faith by Debbie Turner Bell that I read a few months back. She's a business leader, journalist, and the 1990 Miss America winner. I read a few months ago that Debbie recalled describing what a tough week that the week prior to the Miss America TV show. It was constant motion, making sure things were ready and making sure that you had practiced the right things to say. And I can say this past week has been a lot like that for me. I'm grateful that I did not have to do it all in high heels like she did. For all of you who have participated throughout the planning and execution and eventually the cleanup of the Plaid Day event, thank you. It has become apparent how the presence of Christ has been with us throughout. So in our text from Acts, the disciples are getting really anxious, wondering what is going to happen next. Jesus changes their focus into what they will do through the Holy Spirit instead of asking him what he is going to do for them. Jesus says, you will receive power when the Holy Spirit comes upon you, and you will be my witnesses. We can fall into the same sense of complacency. God, what are you going to do for me? See, Jesus is preparing the disciples with the armor of God to go out into the world to change it, just like you. Now, you may remember someone who has prayed for you through a difficult time. Maybe it's been right here in the prayers of intercession. Many have come to me with tears of gratitude for those prayers. Now imagine, you are one of the early disciples who have walked with Jesus, the Son of God, and he is praying on your behalf. How is it possible to maintain your composure? Now, what I want you to understand is that the disciples Jesus was praying for was not just those sitting around him. It was every disciple who would ever walk the face of the earth. Do you know who that is today? It is you. Jesus prayed that God would give you the same protection, the same guidance to go and be one in the Spirit with each other for the sake of the world. See, God gives the power to serve in ways that we cannot imagine on our own. So I'd like you to consider for a moment, what is your superpower? That's a question you hear often in today's pop culture. You'll find jokes about it on Facebook or the internet, such as, I can make coffee disappear. What's your superpower? Traditionally, we've associated superpowers with superhuman abilities. But in today's world, it doesn't mean what you think. It's not a pretend game of whether you identify with Superman or Spider-Man or Iron Man or Wonder Woman. In today's culture, your superpower represents something, well, unique to you. A unique gift or ability within you that enables you to do something that others can't, or maybe they just don't. For some, it may mean, well, succeeding in business or to be a great cook. For others, it may mean winning at a certain video game or playing the piano or singing really well. Knowing your superpower doesn't really mean others don't have that gift too. But it means that this particularly unique gift, this ability that you have, sets you apart. And well, makes you, you. It's a way in today's common slang to say, this is my particular strength that is greater than all my others. Understanding your superpower can help you make healthy career choices, can help you choose a spouse, can make good decisions, or simply give you an advantage in daily life. So I'll ask you again, what is your superpower? Like people, churches need to ask, what's unique to us? What's our superpower? But there's something else that's important in asking that question within the church, something that we can't find anywhere else in culture, because a church's superpower always starts with Jesus. Jesus always begins with the supernatural touch of the Holy Spirit's power. Because you see, your superpower in culture may not be anything other than your natural ability. What some churches do with the power that Christ gives them is they sit on it. They sit on it. And then you know what happens next? They get lazy. What you did this weekend and will do again in the fall was not lazy. This Plaid Festival and what we will do at our Raise Your Spirits Fall Festival is ambitious. Because we're reaching out to a community, reaching out to a community with the Holy Spirit and with love. You harnessed all the power God is giving you and welcomed hundreds of people who you touched for the sake of the gospel. You didn't sit and wait for someone else to do it or for God to do it. As we head into Pentecost next weekend, please be asking God, how will I be fired up for the sake of the gospel? How will you be fired up for the sake of the gospel as the momentum of our community of faith continues to build for Jesus' sake?